Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Oblong Polka Dots and my name is Kerr, and on this channel we talk about makeup, skincare, and beauty. So if that's something you're into, you've come to the right place. Today we have a mostly blush haul and mostly from Ulta. So let's see. I'm going to take everything out of this bag so I'm not making a ton of racket and we'll get into it. Some of these things, I don't know. I don't think I got anything in here from the 21 Days of Beauty, pretty sure. But I do know that everything I grabbed was probably when they were doing like the 5 and 10 times the points. So this is kind of a cumulative haul. And then on top of it, there is one item for sure that did not come from Ulta. Two items that did not come from Ulta. So I'll start with those two. The first one is this blush from Moira Cosmetics. Normally, I can only find this online, but if you live in Seattle, they do sell Moira at Fred Meyer. So they have a little end cap with not very many products, but they do have the Moira there. So let's see. I'm going to open this up. The blush that I picked up is the Signature Ombre Blush in number 4 Morning Sunshine. Now, I already have one of these, but I grabbed this one. And I was going to grab another one, but I decided not to. Let me cut this open. They do come with a little plastic thing that's on the top to keep people from tampering. So we'll cut that open, and then I'll show you what the blush looks like. Using my tweezers to open it. I don't know. Do you guys have trouble opening stuff when you have like acrylic nails or when you have... press-ons, I always just grab my little pair of tweezers and slide it in there to open it. So this is what the blush looks like. It's one of these really beautiful ombre blushes. And yeah, Morning Sunshine. Let's open it so you can see it without the glare. You guys, seriously, do I always have trouble opening packaging? So this is what the packaging looks like. This is what the blush looks like. It's really pretty. I don't think it's really being washed out now, but these are the colors. And when you blend them all together, it's gorgeous. Plus, I really love the embossing that's on the blush. It's got a little butterfly and some flowers. Yeah, I really like the other one that I have, so that's why I grabbed this one. It's very pigmented, so if you are new to makeup or you're new to blush in general, I would go ahead and take that blush and take a brush like this, do like, let me show you what I'm talking about. Sometimes it's hard to describe. I have closed this twice now, and now I gotta open it again. Y'all, this video is already off to a rough start. Anyways, when you have your blush, when it's really pigmented, after you swirl your brush in there, take your brush and diffuse some of the pigment on the back of your hand, and then put it on your face, and that way you don't have to worry about picking up too much product. So we're not walking around real clown-like, you know? Okay, the other product that I grabbed is from Amazon, and this is the... Oh, they packed it really well, didn't they? Can I slide this out of here? I don't know. Oh, there we go. I hope I didn't just break that. No, I didn't. This is from Wet n Wild, and it is in the shade Naked Brown. The reason I grabbed this is because they don't have this over at Ulta, and I wanted to see what this blush would be like. I'm going to swatch this one just to see. There we go. And come on. Come on. Oh my gosh. I know I always say it, but it's true. They put the packaging on there, and it's like, do you want us to use the product? So this is what Naked Brown looks like. And I'm going to swatch it. Ooh, it's very buttery and soft. This is a really nice formula. Okay. So that's what it looks like on the finger. It's kind of faint there. And then this is what it looks like swatched. So... bring it back a little bit. On my skin tone, it looks like a light sort of mauve-y color. So we're going to see what that looks like, if I can build it up or whatever, when we get to it. So you will see this blush in a future video. Okay, next. Yeah, everything else I have in front of me did come from Ulta. So recently I discovered that Essence had a blush that was actually like would work. Oh no, this isn't right, you guys. Hold on. I'm a mess in this video. Ooh, these came from Amazon. These two. They didn't come from Ulta. What happened was I was looking for them at Ulta because I discovered there was one blush that Essence had at Ulta that worked with my skin tone. However, when I tried to find another blush that worked with my skin tone, I couldn't find one. So when I was searching for these, I found them on Amazon. I realized that Essence has more blushes than what Ulta was carrying. Boy, that was quite an explanation. But nonetheless, I found two that I thought would work. This one is called Goldie Cassis, and it's number 3. And that's what that looks like. I think it'll work for me. Ooh! I just put a little dent in it right there. Can you see that? Dang nabbit. Well, we're about to swatch it anyway, so it doesn't... Ooh! It's so creamy! I don't know if you can tell the texture from here, but it is satiny and creamy. It's a powder, but wow, this is really, what a surprise. Okay, let's swatch it. We're gonna go right here. Oh, okay. On camera, I think it's coming off a little light, but in person, it's the equivalent of a blush with a highlight in it. So that's what that looks like. Very pretty. The other one that I grabbed, and let me get my wipes because I didn't realize I was going to be doing all this swatching. Let's do this, clean this off, clean that off, because we'll swatch some more here in a second. So the other one I grabbed is a pink color, and it's called Bold Heart, and it's number 4. And I'll open this so you can see it without the glare. That's Bold Heart. This reminds me of, I think I have a blush that's this tone from either NARS or maybe NYX, but let's swatch it and see what it looks like. Just as silky as the other one. This is such a pretty formula. And there you go. That's the swatch right there. So I wouldn't say that these blushes are as pigmented as the first one that I tried, but I do think that once I apply them, they're going to look really nice in the face. And I believe, if I recall, they're buildable. So if you are a tone like me, or even a little bit deeper, you might want to try these out. Let me hold these up so you can see them. You might want to give them a try just to see if they work. And since we're in a swatching mood, let's go back to that Moira number 4 Morning Sunshine, and we're going to swatch this too. So for this one, I'm just going to kind of like just swirl like that. Ooh. Wow. That is very pink. Can you see that? That's like a bubblegum pink. Let's see what it looks like. Oh my gosh. I don't know, you guys. We'll see. It's a cool toned bubblegum pink on my skin tone. So, yeah. This definitely reminds me of that. Dior also reminds me of the one from Juvia's Place. So, we're going to see how that works. We're going to figure that out. So, for the next ones I grabbed, this is a brand that I absolutely loved. And when I first swatched these in store, they were the last. I bought two of them already that I really loved. These are the two I hadn't bought yet. But I thought, you know what? I want to complete my collection. One of those deals. I don't always buy stuff to complete my collection, but in this case, I really wanted to. This is from Mented, which is a Black-owned brand. And I have Peach for the Stars and Pinky Promise. This is a fantastic brand. It's sold at Ulta. Let me show you what these look like. We're going to start off with Peach for the Stars. Their blushes have not disappointed me at all. They are absolutely beautiful. I really love the packaging. It reminds me of NARS, that kind of like velvety feel. And then this is what it looks like. It does come with a mirror. So this is Peach for the Stars, and I'm gonna swatch it. It does have a little bit of gold in it, so some gold reflect, and I'll show you what it looks like. These are a much drier formula compared to the Essence and the Moira. But that's the swatch right there. And here it is on my hand. I hope you can see that okay. So, like I mentioned, there is a little bit of gold reflect in there, and it's not really coming out on camera very well. Let's see if I can get a better swatch. This formula is definitely dry. It's buildable, but don't let it deceive you. If you're not careful, you will overdo it with this blush. So for the other one that I grabbed, it is in the shade. I'm only putting them back in the box so I remember to grab for these first in my collection. I promise I'm going to get rid of the box later. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I have an issue with saving boxes. So I've learned to like start getting rid of them, but I have a process. So this is Pinky Promise. And let's open this one. Now, it was either Peach for the Stars or Pinky Promise. One, I was like, eh. Okay, it was Peach for the Stars. Pinky Promise was a little more promising. Huh, get it? This also has a gold reflect in it, and it is a cool tone pink. So I must have really been on a cool tone pink kick that day. And this is what the swatch looks like. This one right here. And then we're gonna swatch it on the hand. Think you can see it better back here. So this peachy or pinky kind of golden color is one that I seem to be gravitating towards because I swear the last few blushes I picked up, even aside from the ones that we're sharing in this video, they've all had like a very similar DNA. So I just must be on a roll with that. But yeah, I like the Mented brand. I think that they make a really great product. I especially love their eyeshadows. If you guys have not purchased their eyeshadow palettes, run, do not walk, and grab one because they grab both of them. They sell them at Ulta. They are so beautiful. Talk about a luxurious feel or high-end feel for something that's a little more upper end but still accessible for the price point. And the thing is, since they sell them at Ulta, you can wait for them to go on sale. Okay, so NYX came out with these new jumbo multi-use face sticks, and I think they're supposed to be marketed similar to like a blush, like a stick blush. So this is in the shade Blueberry Muffin, and I'm going to open this for you. So you can see what it looks like. To me, it doesn't look like a blueberry muffin at all. It looks very pink. And we'll swatch it right here. And it definitely has an iridescence to it. So I thought that might be fun since I'm not necessarily a highlighter girl. I think I got rid of all my highlighters in my last declutter because I just don't reach for them. I really don't. But a blush that has like a highlight in it or you can blend in is something I will reach for just to try it out. So that's what that looks like. Isn't that pretty? I like it. So you can really use it more like a highlight or a topper. You can use it on the eyes. So I'm gonna fiddle around with it and see what I can do. I'll incorporate it in a look coming up so you guys can see it too and see how it wears. Next up, we have some of my absolute favorite blushes in the world. Okay. Aside from Black Radiance, I really love the blushes that are from NYX. So I grabbed a few more of these Sweet Cheeks blushes just to round out my collection. I grabbed four of them. So I have these two, and I have these two. And let's see what they look like. So I think I already have, let's see. In my collection right now, I already have these three. And of these three, they are Bang Bang, Fig, and Citrine Rose. And you guys have seen me use Bang Bang like a ton. I love this formula. I think it feels really good and it wears really well. It stays on my face all day long. I don't have any trouble with it. Let's grab some scissors. Y'all, I moved everything around. If you've been following my videos, you know that I finally did a shop my stash, so I changed the layout of my drawers, and now I keep reaching for things in the wrong drawer because I'm like, I don't know where it is. So this first one is going to be Summer Breeze. And this is Summer Breeze. It's just a really beautiful, warm terracotta brown, which is half of the blushes that I have are this shade. I swear they are. It just works really well with my skin tone, and I love them. I think they're beautiful. Let me swatch this one at least for you, even if I don't swatch the others. It has a nice velvety feel to it, and that's what it looks like. They're pretty pigmented, so if you do plan to use these, just keep that in mind, because you don't want to overdo it. So beautiful, though. Like I mentioned, the formula is gorgeous. It is not, this camera is not doing it justice. You guys, I'm about two steps away from getting a real, actual filming, vlogging camera, like a grown-up. I think that if we hit like 500 subscribers, I'm going to actually invest in a real camera, because then I'll feel like the channel's really going somewhere. Not that it's not going somewhere now. I love you guys. You know I do. But I'm just saying in terms of like a financial commitment. So this one is called Daydream. This is the salmony pink color one, and I have not seen this one in person, so we're gonna see how this works with my skin tone. But that's what this one looks like. Very pretty. I like it. Ooh, we should swatch it. Let's swatch it. Why not? We're on a roll already. So let's see. Oh, it's so faint. Oh no, I was not expecting that. Mm-mm. Okay, we're gonna have to play with this one. We'll see what happens. Hopefully it's buildable. That would be good, because otherwise it's definitely not for my tone, and I'll have to pass it along to somebody else. All right, next up we have, what is this? Rose in Play. I should wear my glasses when I do these so I can see what I'm talking about. So this is Rose in Play, and as one would expect, this is a rosy tone. Again, this is kind of a dusty pink, that kind of bubblegum pink. I don't know what was going on, you guys. I swear I ended up buying the same blush like three or four times. Can you see this? Let's swatch it. I'm not sure this is going to work for me at all, but I bet you it'll work for somebody that I know. We're going to try it, but no promises. This is incredibly light. This is me trying to round out my collection. Next time I better just pay attention to what these tones and shades look like, huh? And then the last one I'm pretty sure will work for me. This is called Red Riot. I'm gonna cut this one open too. Ah, yes, Red Riot. This will work for me. This definitely looks like a blush that I have from MAC. Very similar. So, and it also looks like a blush that I have from Black Radiance, I think. Let's swatch this one. I bet you this one is pigmented. So that's what that looks like. And that's what the swatch looks like. Yeah. Yep. This will work just fine. This formula, surprisingly, I didn't think that I would like it when I first swatched it, because this formula for the Sweet Cheeks matte blushes is very, very dry. Dry like a bone dry. Dry like the desert dry. Dry like, you know, a bad comedian dry. So I was like, okay, well, let's see. But when I began to work my brush into it and put it onto my face, I loved it. I loved the way that it sat on my cheeks, because my cheeks will get oily throughout the day. So I feel like a matte blush just clings better and it stays in one spot. Whereas a lot of the other blushes that I'll use, I like the formula, just like I do for Essence, where it's kind of a silky formula. Eventually throughout the day, it'll come down on my face a little bit. So I feel like with these matte Sweet Cheeks blushes, I do a little bit better for wear. So, oh, I have one more product here. This is from Juvia's Place. It is one of their new bronzers, and this is in the shade Amber. And let's take a look, because I didn't swatch this or anything. I think I bought this online. I have not seen this in person, so I just went off of what I thought would be the right shade. You know how that goes. Sometimes it's right, and sometimes it's not. So this is what the packaging looks like. Very nice. This puts me in the mind of Danessa Myrick's packaging a little bit. And that's what that looks like. And the reason it puts me in the mind of it is this is not one of the flip lids like you would normally see. It's a twist lid. And her packaging also favors a twist lid. So I feel like this is a nice reddish chocolatey, more on the chocolatey side than red. So I feel like this is going to be a good bronzer for me. We're going to test it out in a video and we'll see what it looks like. Hopefully it's not too deep. I picked one that I thought would be the right shade, but we will finesse it. We'll figure out a way to work it. Maybe it'll be an excuse for me to try the, what do you call that? The underpainting. I might be able to try that using this. So I think that's everything for today. Looking around to make sure. Yes, that's it, you guys. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. I really appreciate it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and I will talk to you soon. Take care.